Welcome back to World Mechanics. Today we're going to show you how to remove and replace the oil pan or the oil pan gasket on a Dodge. Or this one is a Dodge Magnum with a 3.5 or Dodge Charger with a 3.5 engine Chrysler. They have the 300 model, have that 3.5 as you can see right here, V6. So stay with us to see how we're going to do that, guys, and show you what you need to do. And don't waste time trying to figure it out. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for one new video every day. Alright, guys, we have the car on jack stand so we can be actually underneath it. And as you can see, this is the oil pan right here. First, we will need to drain the oil with a 13 mm socket. You will need to remove the drain plug. That way we will not have oil in the oil pan. And just drain the whole oil, and after you're done, screw the oil plug back on it so it doesn't drip on you while working on the vehicle next. Okay, guys, next thing that we will need to do, we need to remove two bolts, one here and one right there. Okay, let me get a better view. This one on the nut size is 18 millimeter socket, and the other one is 15, the bolt is 15 itself. So you need to loosen it and take the nut off, and then you need to pull the bolt out. Okay, for this one there, as you can see. And then we need to do this one here, the same thing. Okay, we removed that nut as well, as you can see right there. And now you need to pull the bolts out. They might be stuck pretty good, so you might need to use the ratchet to turn them or lift a little bit. Move it up and down and it will come out of there. But it's pretty tight fit and it's a long bolt. Okay, right there, guys. And as you can see, the rack and pinion is about to drop down now. So you need to hold it with one hand and remove the second bolt as well. Just the same procedure. Okay, guys, this is the second bolt now. And now, if you move out of the way, it will come loose. You don't need to remove the lines or anything like that. That's good. You have enough room to drop the oil pan now. Okay, guys, now with the 10 millimeter socket, you need to remove that plastic cover right there. Okay, it's just one bolt with 10 millimeter, and now you can just go ahead and pull the plastic out of there. Next, with the 15 millimeter socket, you need to remove that bolt right there. Okay, the one right there, you need this one, this, and there is one more right here. That's the one that the oil pan bolts onto the transmission housing. So you need to remove all four of those. And then with a 13 millimeter socket, you need to remove all these bolts around the oil pan. And there is some right here. I think here are two nuts actually. And the one on this side. So you need to remove all those around the oil pan. We're going to count and tell you exactly how many there are. Okay, guys, as you can see, we removed all these bolts around the oil pan and on this side as well, all of them. Only thing left right now is we have one bolt under the oil filter, but we'll remove that one last so we don't make a mess. And we removed the two nuts that were right here on the front as well. But now, one more thing, guys, very important. There is two hidden bolts that you need to go ahead and remove with an Allen wrench 5 millimeter. Okay, there, right there, two black bolts, one there and one right there. With a 5 millimeter Allen wrench, an extension and a swivel arm, you'll be able to get it out. Okay, guys, as you can see, with the extension and with the Allen wrench 5, you can go ahead and remove them like that. It's not very convenient at all, but that's how it is. As we remove the oil filter now and all the bolts, and now it's still pretty stuck because the gasket is still holding. And if you just move it back and forth like that, it'll get loose. And before we proceed, you need to remove the oil dipstick right here, because it goes in the oil pan and you won't be able to pull the oil pan out of there because of the dipstick. So, okay, this nut right there, just to show you where it is. This one, you need to take, it's actually a bolt, you need to take it off all the way. Okay, now you can see the transmission line on the back right there. Two lines are holding it still there, so we cannot slide it forward. If you get a big screwdriver, you can fly them over a little bit, okay? Just don't damage them, be careful not to damage them, but that way the whole pen will come out of there. I mean, you can see already how much room we got. If you cannot make them go over there, what you need to do, you need to remove that bracket that holds them to the AC compressor, okay, right there with a 13 millimeter socket. You can see where that one is on the bottom. It's hard to get a better view for you guys, but that's the best we can do. And just take the bolt all the way and the bracket will be able to move to the side. Alright guys, now if you pull it all the way down, pull a lot down, it will come out of there. And that's the old pen, guys, right here. And as you can see how much water that thing has, it has water damage. And this is the gasket right there, so if you have a leak, you just need to pull it out and replace it with a new one and put it back together the same way we took it apart. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a like. We have a new video every day.